Hello, I'm Marcina, the oldest daughter of Frank and Beulah Beatrice Hampton. As we go down the path of their lives, I am going to tell you a few notable things about my parents. They raised us in a God-fearing home. We never heard our parents argue. We never saw them have a disagreement. They taught us that your home was your haven. That was a place to be happy, to be at peace, and to bring others into our family. Our parents married May 8, 1954, and had 11 beautiful children. We'll start off talking about the oldest son, Lyle. Lyle Raymer, the firstborn son, after high school, got into a trade. He became a journeyman boilermaker and received his second journeyman in welding. Lyle worked in that field for over 40 years, very successful, the oldest son. Lyle has three children, Cherie, Lyle Jr., and Sheila, followed by Frank Hampton III, named after Dad, and our grandfather. He went into drafting, and he now is an entrepreneur owning several rental properties, and that's his twist in life. Frankie is married to Charisse, and Frank has three daughters, Marissa, Erica, and Ava. By now you know I'm Marcina, the oldest daughter, and I graduated from high school, went to college, and was the first one to receive her degree of the 11 of us. After college, I have now worked at Eaton, which was Aeroquip, for 43 years. My career has taken me into a lot of different places and cells, and I've enjoyed the ride. Followed by LaDonna. Donna has one son, Tim, and she is an accomplished painter. She received her associate's degree, and she also has her cosmetologist license. Basil, the third son. Basil has four children, Ambria, Basil Jr., Britton, London, and he is married to Mia. Basil is an entrepreneur. He owns his barbershop, the Hampton Place, following Dad's footsteps, and he also has multiple real estate properties. Anita is the middle child. There's five above her and five below her. Anita has one son, D'Angelo. Her career path she chose was working for the government. She was a property appraiser and assessor for years down in Georgia before she relocated back to Michigan to be that super mom and to bring up her child with relatives. She now is working in the mental health field of helping a lot of people. She's a very patient person that will fight for you. So she definitely has the right job for her. Now, Camilla, the actual Hampton baby. Camilla was the last child born in Detroit before we moved to Jackson. Camilla has five beautiful children, Jasmine, Caitlin, Maurice Jr., Maya, and Amari. Camilla is a mother. She attended high school, graduated, worked at the bank, had a few different jobs, but got married and became a full-time mom. She's a decorator. Oh my goodness. She can do a lot of things, but most of all, her mothering skills are top rated. Now, Beatrice. Beatrice, my mother named her after herself. She is the baby girl. Beatrice has two children. She has Tracy Jr. and she has Lee. Beatrice has worked in manufacturing for over 25 years. Hard worker, makes good money, and loves vehicles. John, as we call him, but Haywood John is named after our great-grandfather. John followed our oldest brother, Lyle, He graduated from high school, went into trades, and he also has two journeymen. John works at Eaton Corporation as I, a hard worker. John is married to Sherry. They have Hayden and Haley. John also has Maya Kira, Nunu, Mariah, and Marquise. Quentin, the second to the last. After graduating, Quentin went into heavy equipment operation. There is no heavy equipment that Quentin cannot master. He also is in highway construction. He's been in that career for over 20 years. Quentin has three beautiful daughters, Katiana, Desiree, and Taylor. Finally, the baby, Lee. Lee is named after my dad's only brother, and Lee is married to Melinda. Lee's career path took him into education, higher education, and he became the vice president of Jackson College. Lee is a full-time pastor, walked in our dad's footprint, and he is a full-time pastor of the congregation that dad last pastored. Lee has 10 children. He has Orlando, Ileana, Lee the second, Justice, Madison, Brooklyn, Ivory, Blake, Gabby, and Isabella. Some of the accomplishments of my parents, my mother Beatrice, in 1950, she began working at a black hospital, Sumby Hospital. There, she worked for Dr. Milton, Dr. Thornton.
The white house up here, big house right here on the left, that's Dr. Thornton's house. Mama worked at the hospital. She worked for both of those doctors.
Granny used to work at Sumby Hospital with Dr. Milton, right here.
But Sumby was an all-black hospital.
She was the manager to your left. Grandma had to work right here. It used to be the hospital.
All-black hospital.
But it was a hospital.
She was the accountant and hospital administrator. We didn't know until later that our mother actually ran the first computer that they had in the state of Michigan. She actually did that for the hospital. Some of her other accomplishments, she was the head of payroll. She took care of all of that for the doctors, all payments for the hospital she took care of. My father, as a licensed barber, owned his own barber shop, and he also worked for the state of Michigan at a boys' home in Northville, Michigan. Then became an interim pastor at Southwestern Church in the early 60s. Became pastor in Jackson, Michigan in 1963. Other accomplishments of my father, we have a wall here of many of his awards, but in 2012, he did the opening prayer for the U.S. Congress.
The prayer will be offered by the guest chaplain, Pastor Frank Hampton, Jr., Church of God, Jackson, Michigan.
Shall we pray?
How did the trip come about? 2 years ago, Lee and I were talking about we need to do a memory of the family so we would have it in the archive so everyone would know how we started and how we became who we are today. So we decided to do this, and finally it came together in November of 2022. The planning of the trip began with to get as many Hamptons as we could together. We decided to charter a bus. And on the bus, we had roughly 50 of us all together going down memory lane to Detroit.
Going down memory lane. One of our first stops is the house where Uncle Lyle and the last baby was Camilla that was born at that house. We're going to tell family history. We're going to find out things that you might not have known about our family, but we're going to find out about it today.
Lord, this is the beginning of it. We want to enjoy it the way we want to remember it. We pray you bless every aspect of it. Thank you for this. Ask you, Lord. Ask you, Lord.
Come join us on our first stop, Auntie Bop's house.
Family, we are at Auntie Bop's house. Auntie Bop is Granny Hampton's cousin, first cousin, and they grew up together. And she was like a sister to Granny Hampton. So she had three children, Pierre, Andre, Kevin. So Auntie Bop is the oldest living person on Granny Hampton's side of the family that we are connected to.
This is Auntie Bop's son, grew up with us. Tell you stories from 40, 50, 60 years ago.
Before they was born.
Who's my DTE money at?
Frankie back there. Frankie back there. All left now.
How you doing, baby girl?
I know we do. Yes, we do.
All left now.
She always had the white leather furniture, always.
Oh, yeah.
With
always.
The plastic over it. The most glitzy house we ever kept it in.
Mama just turned 90.
How old is Dr. Byer?
I think she's
88, okay.
Got your chair behind.
You already.
Right behind. Yeah, leave
me. Royalty. Royalty.
And she didn't want to do no work. She didn't like to wash the
dishes. Your baby. Your baby. I'm 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 your baby, though.
Hi. Wow. That was great visiting Auntie Bop's house. Now, go with me as we travel to the home where the first six Hamptons were born. 26187 West Outer Drive.
Mayo is the Andre. Mayo is the oldest Hampton.
We're gonna let him get away with that.
And Pierre was the oldest Johnson. Mayo first, then Pierre, then Frankie, then Cena, then Andre. On the top floor, second floor of the house with the red stairs, that's the house where we were born, that's where we lived. The top floor, that first window was my bedroom. Me and Donna had that bedroom. To the left of that window, that was a little den in the office where Mom used to work from home. Okay, downstairs, the first window that you see, the first window, I was bad. I was 6 years old, and Granny said we could not leave the porch. We couldn't leave the house. We couldn't play. My girlfriend came up on the porch, and I thought, okay, I can't leave the house. So I sat in the window of that, and when I saw Granny drive down the street on the other side, I opened that window, and it came down and cut my arm, and I had to go to hospital and get stitches. 6 years old.
When we reached our family home, a pleasant surprise, Lyle goes next door to the Larkins' house, and Cassandra Larkins, our neighbor, our babysitter, was actually there. She came over and joined us in pictures. She babysit Lyle, Frankie, Marcina, LaDonna, Basil, and Nita.
Man, this is too much, man.
Boxes where you see pictures. Yes.
Tell me this.
Wow.
Where's Roy's baseball card?
She's our next door neighbor. She babysit us. The only person our parents would allow to babysit us.
We need all the boys.
Hey, Frankie.
Everybody.
Story about the Hampton's house. Frank, born here. Frank, tell me about this real quick.
I had a kite. He allowed it. It got stuck in this tree right here.
Wow. I went and got a steel rake and tried to get the kite down, and it fell short. And it hit Lyle in the head, stuck all the blades.
Stuck Lyle right in the head.
Lyle was running the house with a rake.
Oh, wow.
And you said right there reading books?
Right here, the bookmobile would come.
Yeah.
Down on 4th Street. And I would go get my books. Bernstein Bears.
Bernstein Bears.
Bernstein Bears.
Yeah, Bernstein.
You know, up top, Frankie and Lyle's bedroom. The front window is Tina and Donna's bedroom. The living room, the dining room, and Mama's and Daddy's bedroom is that back window.
In the back of the house upstairs, on that little landing upstairs, is the window. And you look, when you go to that window, you can see this street bend right here.
Right.
So Grandma would leave. Yes. We'd go downstairs, we'd crank, we want Grandma to leave, we'd hug and kiss her. She'd get in her Cadillac and she'd leave. We'd run upstairs to that back window, because so look at that back window, press up against the screen, you can see the car turn the corner for a brief second.
Come on. Yep.
And we'd catch that second, that's all we could get.
Yep.
That was Grandma, man.
I ran away from home when I was 6 years old to live with my grandma.
Oh.
For one day.
And she was part of the, what game was she part of?
Okay, I'm not getting no games.
Villain.
I know that was my Lord.
Yes, I have villain. Listen, y'all.
8 years old.
Can you help me
sometimes? You know, I spent the night over here when they went out of town.
Wow. She know more about us than we do.
This is historic. Our baby, the Hampton family babysitter. Isn't that?
Wow. If only Mom and Dad were here to see the legacy, all of us, at their first home. As we travel on our journey, we stop by Mam-Mam's house, our grandmother. She lived on Conway Street and a block from Boynton School, where Frankie, Lyle, Marcina, LaDonna began kindergarten.
This is the store we went to, me, Lyle, and Frankie.
I was in kindergarten.
Yep, Boynton School, right on your right. That's Boynton School that we went to. I went to kindergarten. Oh, that's my twin.
That was the dentist's office.
Okay, we're going by our grandmother's house. It's no longer there, but it's on this street.
And I was a painter.
That's
where
my mom be playing
her piano teacher, her cousin. Remember?
Where?
Right there.
Yep.
The brick up when we play piano.
Lau, you play piano?
Yeah. I wrote music too, Johnny. I'm a composer.
All of us spent the night there, had every holiday like we have it at our house. It was always at Grandma's house. Yes. We would drive from Jackson. When all the little kids were born.
Remember the candy cane.
And then we go to Auntie Barbara's house. And okay, and another memory of Mam-Mam's house is that in the front room, Granddad would always be sitting there, and he liked these orange pieces of candy called what, Nita?
Circus peanuts.
Circus peanuts. He liked circus peanuts. He always ate dentine gum. We could have that at his house all the time. Candy canes.
Candy corn. Records. Mahala Jackson Records, Martin Luther King, and Reverend Franklin Records.
Yeah. And press our hair on that iron.
Oh, what did Grandma do for a living? What did she do? Make hats?
Grandma was a beautician. She was a hat maker, and she could cover shoes. So whenever she went anywhere, her shoes and hat matched.
And her purse.
And her purse. She made them to match.
Wow. Where did Grandpa work at, and what kind of car did he drive?
Cadillac and a Ford. Great Lakes deal.
This house was very significant. Very significant. Your parent is a Hampton. House was very significant.
When I lived in Atlanta, when I first came to Michigan, this was the first place I stopped.
I went to the barbecue, and Barbara Jean came over. She was fine. I was a kid, knew that.
Still fine.
I was a kid, though. And Daddy seen her, and he he got ready to say something. She said, come on, Frank, don't. He was getting ready to go there. She knew he was getting ready to go there. But this is where, yesterday, when we did the trivia yesterday, and I asked you guys about that little scar on Marcina's nose, this is where she got it. She got that scar on her nose right there. That scar right there. She got it right here at this house.
I got a question, Frank. Okay,
we had all our holidays here.
The younger ones, QH, we would leave the Springfield meeting and we would come up here. So they would come up here and they would save quarters, Grandpa, nickels and dimes. And he would split them between us three.
Yeah.
And I look at the pennies and I seen the big old thing. It's which ones you want? I want the big one. Johnny take the little one at the quarters in it. I take the pennies and I'm thinking I got a whole bunch. Johnny end up way more than me and Quentin. Yeah. And we go in the backyard, shoot the BB gun, had a BB gun in here. We go in the backyard, get the BB gun, sneak in the backyard, shoot cans off the fence. Oh, yep. Memories.
One of our stops was the Palmerston Street Church of God, where my mother got saved when she was 11 years old. My dad also got saved at that church. Many memories, Lyle, Frankie, and I growing up there, going in the church, the different older saints giving us a peppermint. Those were beautiful days.
Yep, that was Daddy's barbershop down there. Where? To the right is the new River Ridge High School.
It's the new one.
State football champs.
Mama
graduated. That's the new one.
We used to skip church and go get candy at the store.
Oh, I promise.
Right here's the store. Remember, I know the church is that way.
Brother Hampton's first church. This is where he preached his first sermon at. Got called to the ministry at. This is historical. We're going to show you this one, Southwestern, High Street, then South Street. 60-year ministry started right here. This is where it all started.
Started from.
Last person who
was shouting at the church.
Who was?
Hey, I'm right here.
Hold
up. Let me. Let's go, man.
Yeah.
Come on,
yes,
man.
Yes, I remember this. I totally remember that.
Got us on Brother Hampton's lap. Amen. Mama taking care of her. Come on, the nursery, right in that building, right there. It's where it all started.
This is where we all started. Lily wasn't born yet.
We left the Palmerston Street Church. We came over to Southwestern, where our father was the interim pastor.
This is the church that Pastor Hampton was interim. Then he began to commute to Jackson. Before the Jackson Church of God was this.
Southwest Church of God.
Go church.
Southwest Detroit.
They came from Palmerston Street before they came to here.
So Papa was the interim pastor between the
two. Come on. Hey babe, Linda, online member, faithful. You hear me? Thank you. Faithful online. Come on.
Our final step in the neighborhood was stopping by the twins. The twins were some of the first young people that my mom and dad met in the Church of God. They have so many memories of our parents and were there when they got married and have been a part of our family our whole entire life.
These are Brother Hampton's closest young people. They grew up in the Young People Church together. They're both right here. They're the twins. They are just the world about y'all. It's the world about the children. They tell you everything you want to know about Brother Hampton before he got married. These are the twins. They daddy's closest people on earth. Love y'all. You say Frank Jr. and they just, oh my. All right, now we with the twins. They go back further with Pastor Hampton than anybody alive. Anybody alive. He crazy about them. Come on now.
But I was with Daddy when he climbed the church.
Come on. Come on, they precious to us. They mean the world to us. They mean everything to us.
Joe Gallo, we ain't gonna let them go.
Come on.
Man.
We ain't let them go.
All of our life, they've been a part of our family.
Henry, come on.
Every wedding, everything we did in life, they were there.
Right there.
Everything.
Isn't that
something? Everything.
Oh, Daddy, crazy about them. Oh, man.
You do it? Daddy, oh.
She wants prayer for her. The twins, when they requested prayer, there's a confidence that they've consistently demonstrated regarding what they call Frank Jr., his children, regarding faith. And I look and we gather around. Siblings begin to pray. And I'm hearing, in the name of Jesus, Father, rebuke the devil. Lord, build up. Lord, touch. Lord, intervene. Lord, you're the same, Lord. Father, many of them saw great things back in the 50s. But here in the prayer, building up their faith that the God of the 50s, if we do right, is the God today. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Something's gone, it's all over. It ain't over. It ain't over.
In 1963, my father got his calling and came to Jackson, Michigan, where he pastored the Church of God on High Street. That's where the church took off and began to grow the Jackson, Michigan congregation. Some of the first members of that church was the Page family, and today Sister Betty Page is still in our congregation. The Holmes family, we still have some of the Holmes children and grandchildren a part of our congregation.
I see Jackson Church! I see Jackson Church! I see Jackson Church! Daddy's
This is our first time
we
came to Jackson.
Yep. We began coming to Jackson, Michigan in 1963. Granny could not come initially because she had just had a baby, Anita. We've been coming to this church as long as Anita was alive until we moved to South Street, I think, in 1972.
Right over there.
Daddy had to get Mom out the window. We got locked in the church.
When we left Detroit in 1967-1968, we moved to 207 Summit Street, Jackson, Michigan. Wow, the last four children, Beatrice, John, Quentin, and Lee, were all born there. What special, blessed memories. That's the house where Granny Hampton would have morning Bible classes with the whole neighborhood in the summer. All the children would gather together and would listen to her Bible stories and her praying with the neighborhood. Children began getting saved and the church began to grow. In 1977, we moved from 207 Summit Street that fall to 116 Rockwell. There, we lived across the street from the church's nurse, Sister Linda Holmes, and Around 50 children lived in a 2-block radius. All of the saints, I mean, there were so many of us. All the children lived there, and there are many, many, many memories.
Oh, yeah. Yes, oh, yeah. The bubble gum lady still there. This is where we at.
Look at that. We're born here, but this was the greatest memory.
One of the greatest memories is meeting him.
Because
this is
the only house I've
never got a hoop
in.
No,
we
don't
care.
He
stopped drinking a baby's bottle here. That was it. It was over.
As the High Street Church congregation grew and grew, in the early 70s, we moved over to 140 West South Street. We began in the small part, which is now the kitchen, and it grew into what it is today.
Enduro Photo Hampton family, as we're creating this documentary regarding our family history. This is the pulpit where our father preached his last message, passed away a couple weeks later. Our mother sat right over there. 2008, she made her promotion. He went in 2018. Here we are, 4.5 years after his passing, taking this photo. And we're heading over to take a photo at the original church on South Street, on the other side. Then we're gonna just march to the other side.
Okay.
Go forward, lead us out, march to the other side. March to the other side. This is South Street Church. Camilla was first one.
Church ended right
here. Okay, because Lyle is trying to say that was indoor when that was outdoor.
That was. This was the door to go into. This was the door.
Frank, do you remember the building? You remember the building over here?
This was when I first got here.
This is
the
church.
Kamala,
how old were you when we moved?
That's the girls' bathroom.
I was 2 years old when we came to
78.
Jackson.
Yeah, this
at this
was
building, I'm not sure how old.
What year did we move here? I think we moved to the building 70.
Yeah. This was cement right here to walk to that door.
But the bathroom, that was the woman's bathroom. This was the wall.
This was the sanctuary.
Yeah, this was the sanctuary was right here. And now this is where we eat at. Somebody give us a memory in this church.
Okay.
You remember
Brother Neese was an usher. Yeah.
Brother
Neese
was an usher. Brother
Keith Lee.
Brother
Keith
Lee.
Esau
Lee.
Brooks
piece
over here.
Esau Brooks did. Honduras.
Esau Brooks.
Esau Brooks.
Brother.
Emerson Wilson.
Emerson Wilson.
Emerson Wilson.
Yes.
Emerson Seven Sealer.
Aaron.
Yeah. Alsop.
Kenny
Alsop.
Kenny Alsop.
His choir sung there.
What about Wingate?
What about the Kalamazoo?
Wingate did.
The Alexanders were here.
What's the lady who's her husband?
Brother James. Brother James. Brother James from last. Brother James from last.
Daddy firmly.
Listen,
disciplined me. And I got so upset, I walked out of the church. Walked out of here.
Yep,
and I walked over there to the projects, that little project right there. I was like so mad, I just walked out of the church. Daddy go always got disciplined me somewhere. You know what I'm saying?
Last bench in the church was about right here, the last row of benches. And you can walk to the bathroom there. And this is on this bench here, at the end of service, Johnny, Quentin, and Lee fell asleep. And we almost left Lily and I think Quentin. Because they had to go out that way.
I remember Rose Griffin and Chris Hunt.
Yep, they were here.
Wow.
B. Warren. All of them started over here.
The original site of 140 West South Street, where we first came, before they put the addition on, before the first fire. This is where we left from
High Street
to here. And this is where when the church grew. This church right here is a result of that overgrowth. And then we expanded from here.
What
year? 1972, according to Marcina. I beg a different, but we won't go with Marcina.
All right. I just want to say hi to Sister Bessie Draw, Nathaniel Draw.
Oh.
In 1979, we had outgrown that, and we added an addition, which is the front of the South Street Church, where we are now. The pews were olive green. In early 1990s, we updated to the blue pews, and in 2005, added an addition to the front of the church, which is now our current sanctuary. as we talk about the current church where we are today, 140 West South Street, where Dad ended his ministry, I'll pass it on to Lee to tell the rest of the story.
Pastor Hampton's study, he would come in here and study, he would counsel people. He would, I remember how many counseling sessions that he had in here. Some in the later years, I would join him with counseling people. He prospects for marriage, some people that were dealing with afflictions or perhaps took a stand out of Babylon and they wanted a better understanding. He would meet with them in here and discuss things. He would study, you know, he had, he's a man of great study. He would study various commentaries and scriptures and history and things of that nature, yeah, quite a bit.
2004, the house was empty on Rockwell Street. All the children gone, mom and dad living there alone. And mom was just beginning to get sick. So they moved to 245 East High Street. And here is where they lived until they passed away. And currently, I'm living here. Mom and dad wanted it to stay in the family, wanted us to have family gatherings and family memories. And I can honestly say, this is the family house. Thanksgiving every year is held here. Family is here every day. There's not a day that family doesn't drop in. It has the feeling of mom and dad. Their presence still lives on. Thanks everybody for joining us as we have gone down memory lane, talking about memories, what our parents instilled in us. Pray about everything, and the family that prays together stays together. We're doing all we can to follow right in our parents' footsteps of being saved, being true to God, and more than anything, keep the family together. Family, hopefully you've enjoyed this documentary. Our parents' last request for all of us was stick together, share, love one another. And I can honestly say all 11 of us and all of the grandchildren, great-grandchildren, we stick together. The love that our parents poured into us, that love has expanded 100 strong. We love you, family.
No, Camilla.
Not hey, Camilla.
We don't got
it.
Camilla,
we got each other. Mm-hmm. We got it. Thank you. Come on, I ain't playing with you.
We shall remain strong.